Good afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87. And as always, those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath. Now, I'm going to spend a few minutes today talking about something that we're all familiar with, and that is bitterness. And I'm just going to give some perspective on what the Word says about it and a different approach as to what we should be doing about it, because there's nothing worse than a person who's bitter. Bitter in the workplace, bitter about relationships or men that are bitter about women. It's very destructive. Bitterness is spiritual poison for those who are trying to live their life righteously, and for those who are just living, it's just poison. So, with that being said, let's talk about bitterness for a few minutes. Now, first of all, let's understand simply what bitterness is. Bitterness is a deep-rooted ill will toward others. And this is a problem because when you're harboring ill will or a hatred toward someone or a situation or what have you, it causes you to be a certain way in the character you display. It becomes you because you're holding on to something that's not yours to hold on to. Now, we're told in Romans 12:19, the Father says for us to not avenge of ourselves. Let Him do that. He'll take care of these things. But people don't do this. They want someone to pay when they're hurt or disappointed or what have you. So then they start harboring this ugly, bitter attitude, and it causes you to be a murmurer, complainer, a hater, a criminal even. I mean, people have killed people behind bitter hatred and things like this. We have to let this go and let the Father handle His work. We're to love our neighbor, love thy neighbor as thyself. People don't understand and refuse to understand the power of loving someone, because that is so much more powerful and so much more controlling than these bitter and hateful attitudes that we have. These types of attitudes affect us more than the person we're trying to project it on. If we let these negative situations humble us, the Father will bring us through it a whole lot quicker, and then we will feel that much better about ourselves. And you let the other person go on and be and do whatever they are, and theirs will come when it's time. See, we want things to happen immediately to avenge our hurt feelings and our hurt spirits so that we can allegedly feel better about them doing us wrong. And that's not necessarily going to be true. So anyway, let the Father handle His business. Now, we're also told in Ephesians 4:31. Let me read it to you. It reads, it says, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. It covered everything. Let all that stuff be put away. Don't worry about all that. Let it be gone. Let me tell you something about hanging on to these feelings. This causes us to be defiled. It's not what goes into us that defiles us. It's what comes out of our mouth. This is in Matthew 15:11. Matthew 15:11, it reads, it says, not that which goeth into the mouth defileth the man, but that which cometh out of the mouth, this defileth the man. So we have to be very careful. It's not what goes in, it's what we say. It's that filthy communication, those things that come out of us, which defiles us in the eye of the Heavenly Father. What we're supposed to be doing is to be putting and getting rid of that old sinful individual we are and putting on that new individual that's right in spirit and mind. That's Ephesians 4:22-24. This is what we're supposed to be doing. Now, when we don't do this, when we're being bitter and hanging on to ugliness and being hateful and allowing all this filthy communication to come out of our mouth, we're doing what? We're giving place to the devil. We allow him to come in and take over. And this leads to what? More problems. We are to put on the armor of the Heavenly Father to protect ourselves from this. And the only way to do this is to keep our mind and spirit right. We shouldn't be harboring bitterness and hatred and all these things. These are just pathways, like I just said, for the enemy to get in and steer us in the wrong direction. We are to resist the temptations of the enemy and be steadfast in faith and do what is right. Now, I'm going to tell you, it's not easy to not be upset or feel hurt when something happens to you. But we should not find ways to hang on to the ugliness and hateful attitudes that come with it. Give it up to the Heavenly Father and pray. When you don't study and when you don't pray and when you don't do all the things He wants us to do, when we're not being obedient, the enemy will find a way to come in and disrupt all these things. The Father has all the answers and tells us everything that we need to do to stay protected and in His will. So we have to focus on doing these things or the enemy is going to take over. And in the long term, what's going to happen is when something comes about, everyone's going to look at you as the one with the issue, not at the one that you have this hateful and bitter attitude against, because you're going to be the one to do something that creates the real problem. It all stems from bitterness. Get rid of the bitterness. It is poison. It disrupts your life. There's nothing good that comes from it. And believe me, if something were to happen to someone because you're angry or bitter or hate them, and then what? Anyway, remember, love thy brother as thyself. And with that being said, remember, whatever the question is, He is the answer. This is Tube 87. I'm out.